Ah, shit.
Hey, move it.
Please look into the camera. Smile.
Hello everyone, it's I, your knight in shining armor Paladin Thorn. Today we are going to go over what happened in my latest experiment and talk about the notable events that happened each day. Before we get into day one, let's go over what happened prior to the experiment. There were 8 sections, all with an amount of members ranging from around 15 to 25. Each day, they would vote someone off. Every section would have 5 winners. Those winners go on to the final section, and that's where we are now. 40 people, 2 winners. Here are all the members of the experiment, including what section they happen to be from. I'm not going to bore you with the backstory of each one, however, I will give you information as it comes up throughout the experiment. Now, for the actual lore. With there being 8 sections, each with 5 members, they already have their built-in teams. However, seeing as only 2 people can win, these sections will eventually break down, and people will turn on each other. To add another layer onto the alliances, there are also bigger factions coming out to play. For instance, Misfit, an alliance created by Crazy Crazio, a prominent figure of my last experiment, made an alliance, and this is what I can only say to be one of the most toxic slash edgy ones, made up of figures such as Just That Jerk, Robotic, Cupid, Caitlyn, Zucchini, Flash Guy, Wazdok, and others. This group of Misfits is trying to get Kitty out, because Kitty sent furry porn to Cupid, which Cupid claims they didn't want furry porn sent to them. However, they did kind of ask for it, so it's a bit of a scandal there, which I'll get into later. Another faction we have is Home of the Mastermind, created by The Gamer, and made up of Section 3, Omeg, Just That Jerk, Robotic, and The Best Avatar. These people want Zucchini dead. The Best Avatar, who is in Misfit and Mastermind, wants to cross Misfit because The Best Avatar does not like that toxic group of people. So they've asked The Gamer to help them destroy it. To which he says it's a bit too early to destroy a faction, which is true. Then we have Stinkies, which is basically made up of Section 1, created by Kitty. Think of this group as the anti-Misfits. Then, we also have a bunch of offshoots of Home of the Mastermind, which I'm not gonna bother talking about because they're basically never used. So that's the basics of what you need to know. My guess for who's getting voted out first would be Zucchini, then Kitty, followed by Crazy or someone from Section 8. Now, let's move on to something a little bit less important, but someone wanted me to add this to the video, so, you know, I'm nice, I suppose. So here it is. I'm going off script for this part of the video, and I'm sorry if this is even more ass than the rest of it. So Soup posts a meme where it's a joint infused with gunpowder. Milkman is like, hey, I'm about to do some math on that to see if that would hurt or something. And then Soup's like, that's really cool. Milkman does some math and figures it could blow your fingers off. Milkman and Soup then proceed to do a lot more math. And I mean it, a lot. Milkman comes to the conclusion that it would do around 455.28 joules of force or something. I'm not sure how math works. Though I do think I've seen more kids at my high school with more joules than that. Haha. I made a funny joke. If anyone PayPals me $200, I will make this joint with like gunpowder and shit, because I'm bored, I guess, and I want $200. So now that we have got that out of the way, time to move on to day one. On day one, as you might have guessed, Kitty and Zucchini got overwhelming votes almost instantly. The only thing that happened today was the puzzle. The puzzle is a thing I make where the players have to solve ciphers, gridlocks, etc. And once they finish the puzzle, they get a prize. The only ones to come close to solving the puzzle are Wazduck, Crazio, and Robotic. However, they are still off. The prizes are listed on your screen right now. But the most important ones are Instant Kill and Protection. With Instant Kill, you can kill anyone at any time. With Protection, if you have the most votes, then you don't die. Your protection just breaks, and the person with the most votes under you dies instead. I did have another puzzle when the sections were split up, and the winners of that were Robotic, getting a Protection and Instant Kill, the Gamer, just getting the Instant Kill, and Karen Killer, who got Protection. However, Karen Killer transferred their power over to Soup, where it is now. The last thing I want to touch on is the Kitty and Cupid thing. So basically what happened is Kitty sent not safe to work content to Cupid. Cupid was completely okay with it. Then Kitty asked if they would like to see a furry horse, not safe for work, which Cupid says yes, so Kitty sends it. Cupid claims they didn't read the horse part, so that's what went on there. You decide what you think happened there. I don't want to talk about it. The person to die today was Zucchini. Rest in peace, is, I suppose. On to day two. Day two is when shit hits the fan for the best avatar. The day starts out with Kitty getting immediately voted, garnering 12 votes. Kitty is friends with Avatar, though, and Avatar pinged Home of the Mastermind to vote Cupid since Cupid has 7 votes. However, then Zeal really wants Kitty gone, to which Avatar says after Misfit, the alliance that wants Kitty's head on a pike, will kill Denzel afterwards. Avatar still won't say who is in Misfit to Mastermind, though. The Gamer then messages Cupid, saying that, with proof, Avatar wants to vote for them. Cupid takes it to General, and this is when things sorta get crazy. Avatar backpedals and says to vote Flash Guy after having a conversation with Cupid. However, then Zeal tells Flash Guy that Avatar wants them dead, to which Flash Guy ambushes him in General. This leads to Avatar pinging everyone in Mastermind, asking who is sharing the messages. However, this leads to the second and final deathly slip-up. Avatar, in an attempt to find out who is sharing the messages, pings everyone, telling them to vote for Tina Soup. However, accidentally, he doesn't send it in the Mastermind channel. He sends it in Tech Talk, which Kitty, being Tina Soup's best friend, sees it. Then starts leading a crusade against Avatar. In fact, there's even a Let's Take Down Avatar channel. Avatar is basically public enemy number one. However, Kitty is still on the chopping block this time around. So, today, Kitty died. Gone, but probably forgotten. Not much happened today. Avatar got overwhelming votes and they died. Shame what happens to a person when they think they can game the game. The only remotely interesting thing that happened was a Flash Guy versus Gay Garlic Bread face-off, where GGB drama dumped, kinda, and Flash Guy got their Reddit account and found a picture of them, and they started arguing, and GGB used their ADHD as an excuse for things, I suppose. So, I'll give you a little lore on them. Originally, Flash Guy and GGB were on the same section, however they argued, so I let Flash Guy go to section 2. So it's very lucky that they meet back up in the final server. For this day, I wrote a poem to describe what happened. The GGB versus Flash Guy War spread into day 4. Not much else happened during this day. I, Paladin Thor, will not be getting paid. Milkman, the passive boy, finally voted. Soup ... was very goaded. Manipulating the votes with their pal Darklight made GGB and Flash Guy go night-night. That was the poem. Then Zeal, Katie's really cool, scientific, and the gamer also helped get them both out, but they didn't really fit the rhyme scheme, and it was already too long, it was. So yeah, GGB and Flash Guy got killed this time. Now let's move on to day 5. So on day 1, I mentioned I created a puzzle, and people finally managed to finish it today. The winners of which, there are 4, are Crazy Crazio, whom finished first place and chose protection, Wazdok, who got second and chose the instant kill, NRN, who got third and chose the 3 ghost votes, and The Gamer, who got fourth and chose Revivify. However, continuing the story of nothing happening, everyone decided to vote off an inactive person by the name of Grand Croyce. However, when people pinged them, they suddenly awoke and begged and pleaded not to be voted off. They quickly became annoying and were voted off. Truly a shame. On to day 6. Your kiss was such a sacred thing to me. Tina Soup said women in the men spam chat, which is evil and she should be killed. Along with that, Misfit finally decided to kill Tina, as she kept voting for their members even though she was technically a part of Misfit, though not really. So there wasn't much Tina could do. She did go down swinging though. Otherwise, not much happened today. Rest in peace, Tina. The day started out with Darklight posing most stupid thing in general, hoping people would believe him. Darklight proceeded to get clowned on and Misfit decided to vote for him. However, then shenanigans happened. Soup got their bullshit alliance to attack Robotic, which if you didn't know, has protection. Which means if he had the most votes at the end of the day, instead of dying, he would lose his protection and the person with the second most votes would die, which would be Darklight. However, Katie's really cool, who's in the Bullshit Alliance, likes Robotic and the Misfit people. So she decided to betray the Bullshit Alliance. So she sent a screenshot of the gamer saying Robotic should die, which got the gamer kicked out of Misfits, which he managed to get in during the Avatar scandal of day 2. So now Misfits hates the gamer, and the Bullshit Alliance's plan was foiled. It was a good plan too, since Scientific managed to get the inactives to vote for Robotic. During that mess, Darklight managed to join the Misfits and betray the Bullshit Alliance. So Misfit decided to kill an inactive person instead of Darklight. They chose Criminal Duck. The votes were 14 for Duck and 13 for Robotic nearing the end of the voting period. The gamer voted for Robotic. Robotic, who had an instant kill, killed the gamer, which means his vote was taken off Robotic. Criminal Duck died, and Robotic kept his protection, losing his instant kill. So, Criminal Duck and the gamer both died today. It appears as the tipping point has happened, and now all of the control is in Misfit's hand. They've decided they're going after Soup next, as they are the leader of the Bullshit Alliance. Also, NRN is a character again, which is cool. He talks now. I just thought I should mention that. You know, for the fun of it. On to day 8. I should be happy with someone new, but my heart... Soup left the Bullshit Alliance because they said they were not following their morals and it took a toll on them, though that didn't stop Misfits from voting for them. Scientific, now the new de facto leader of the Alliance, decides to go after Robotic again. However, his efforts pointless, he kills himself. So if Soup has the most votes, that means they'll die, right? However, he has protection, so that means the next person will die. However, if that's robotic, and he has protection, so that means the next person will die. Well, the next person is everyone else, because everyone is tied for third place. So, if only Robotic and Soup have votes on them, everyone will die except Robotic, Soup, and Crazio, because they all have protection. Soup contemplates trying to take down Misfits to save all the good people, however, they decide not to. Everyone dies. So, everyone is dead. Robotic and Crazy quickly vote out Soup. However, before Soup dies, they and Robotic make amends, which is almost beautiful in a way. I didn't think it would be over this soon. Only two people left, Crazy and Robotic. They have to decide who dies. They flip a coin. As the coin hit the table, it was tails. Robotic won. The experiment is over.
The riddle and winning the riddle as it was getting that reward, you know, the prize after all that hard work of asking Robotic for help.
I'd say one of the best ones for me was when the best avatar got outed as the, like, you know,
yeah,
the spy between lines. That was the best witch hunt we've ever seen. It's so good.
Yeah. It was very good.
I like the betrayal of Kitty. That was probably my favorite part.
Because you did it?
Because I did it. I actually had impact for once, so that was really exciting and fun for me.
Honestly, there's a lot to choose from. I also like bullying the absolute shit out of Kitty. That was really funny. I liked watching Robotic and Monk fucking Crazy go like absolutely apeshit over the fucking puzzle, because I kept getting DM'd by both of them like, hey, can you give me answers to the puzzle? Even though I was leeching off of them for answers, it was really funny.
No, not a chance. I always thought my whole thing was that I thought I was gonna get to like the end of like the last maybe 5 people and then get voted out because I wasn't opinionated enough. And I thought that
would
just
be... would have if the mass killing didn't happen.
Yeah. I thought that's the way it was gonna go. So I never thought I'd win, but I was enjoying it just the same.
For me, I thought I was gonna win 100%. I actually made it to the final 2. So after the mass killing, it was me, Robotic, and Soup. We voted out Soup. Robotic said, okay, you can win. And yeah, I said, oh, that's kind of just too nice. Are you sure? Something like that. I don't know. And then we were going to do something, but then we never did it. So we just flipped a coin and I lost.
Yeah, I thought I was going to win.
Did you really?
I really did. I had a well thought out plan. My plan was that I had the knife and I already already assumed that. So obviously I'm like really good friends with Milkman, and Milkman's the most liked person in the experiment, period. Like, Milkman was just a pacifist, and so I'm already really good friends with Milkman, so chances are that I'm never gonna get voted out because of Milkman and being like close to him. But if like the time ever were to where I was getting voted out, I would have just straight up threatened Milkman. I would have told people, hey, I have a knife. If you guys vote me, I'm going to kill Milkman, and then I'll take him down with me.
Uh-huh.
So that was my plan, and then that all of that got completely thrown out the fucking window when all of us fucking died. That was funny.
I wanted Milkman, Robotic, or Cupid to win, or Wazdok, and they were basically my main team.
So I never thought I was gonna win. I thought I was gonna
me
get
neither. Her.
No,
not me neither. I thought you were never gonna win, period. I just wanted to throw that out there and continue.
Actually, I genuinely wanted Wazdok here to win, which...
Oh, I'm flattered.
I know.
It's but because I wanted myself to win. That's what's... I have two people that I wanted, so actually I keep cutting you off. You know, I'm gonna keep cutting you off. If I wasn't gonna win, I would have wanted Milkman to win, which is pretty sour coming from me when I kind of was gonna threaten his life for my own benefit if it ever came to it. So
yeah.
Nothing. It was just for fun.
Shit bites you in the ass. You say anything around these people, they will find you for it.
Actually, that's true. It was the people who weren't racist that got voted out.
Yes, because they were being, like, the Avatar thing is a perfect example. He fucked around. He found out. Like, it's
oh,
that
he did
simple.
What did he even do again?
He betrayed a bunch of people by saying, like, he was like, oh, well, look, I'm with this group of people. I'd never betray you. But then be with a totally different group of people and betray them. And then, like, there came out a screenshot of him telling people to vote out someone that was quite a controversial pick. And then, like, everything just fell on his head. That was so funny.
No. Actually, you know what? I learned that Robotic is a stupid little bitch.
I learned that exploiting people and manipulating them is really funny, and also ghosting servers is based.
That's... You know what, that's pretty real too.
I also don't like Kitty, just to mention that. If Kitty is mentioned in this video, if Kitty is seeing this, I hate you.
When GGB got kicked out, I was over the moon. They were the only person that I actually didn't get along with.
I don't think I'm ever gonna win one, but I hope for this guy.
I'm a girl.
Shut the fuck up. Go make me a fucking sandwich, you slut.
That's definitely going in the video.
No.